Our guest is Sam Giancana. Before we take some calls, what did you think of the statements made by your cousin, Giancana's daughter?
Well, it's really unfortunate that she finds that in our effort to provide additional information about her father and her father's role in American history, that she's found it necessary to look at it in that way.
How about quotes from 20 years ago? She says you have quotes from 20 years ago.
Well, what we've tried to do is try to build the conversation, reconstruct the conversations. We say very specifically that it is not verbatim conversations. We try to distill the essence of the dialogues.
To make it readable.
That's right.
All right, West Orange, New Jersey for Sam Giancana. The book is Double Cross. Hello.
Howard Stern.
Don't know him. Glenn Mills, Pennsylvania. Hello.
Can you tell us specifically that Sam Giancana gave the order to Jack Ruby to kill Oswald?
Well, that was just a situation that was mob protocol. Jack Ruby was overseeing activities there when Oswald was found and captured. It fell to Jack Ruby to make sure he did the job.
What, from your knowledge, would Oswald have been able to tell us had Ruby not been able to do the job?
Well, whether he would have said anything, you know, is obviously a question for history, but certainly he was in a position to implicate a lot of individuals.
He said he was a patsy when he was arrested.
That's right.
An interesting choice of words. Mm-hmm. New York City for Sam Giancana. Hello.
Hello. I'm in the middle of the book. I'm up to about 1946, and I'm curious, do you have any knowledge that Mario Puzo perhaps used Sam Giancana as a model for Vito Corleone in The Godfather? The reason I'm asking is because I've come to two situations so far. One, when Sam Giancana says, I believe to your father, don't ever tell anybody what you're thinking. And number two, the instance with his sister being beaten up by her husband and his rushing across town and that whole scenario.
Well, certainly both of those examples, I think, are typical of being within that kind of world. I think we'd have to ask Mario Puzo who he based his characters on, but I understand it was more New York figures.
When you saw those films, did you feel at home with those people?
Absolutely. Godfather 1 and Godfather 2, we felt like we knew those people.
Pompano Beach, Florida. Hello.
I've been hearing about the Mafia for 50 years, and I'm sure they've cost the taxpayers of this country billions. My question is, since they are such a cancer in the society, why don't we just annihilate them?
Because we have laws.
Well, certainly the United States government and many governments around the world have been trying to get rid of what's been called the cancer in our society.
Well, they have a lot of connections with people in high places, right?
That's right.
You claim they had involvements with other presidents.
That's correct.
Reagan, obviously, Johnson, Nixon, Eisenhower, Truman,
politicians need to get votes, and they go to people who can deliver the vote. And with organized crime figures, especially back into the 20s and 30s and 40s, they were able to control jobs and therefore control people's destiny.